Hi everyone, I'm Digibro. Who are you?
I'm Shade.
Who's that?
Your brother.
That's good to know. I'm drinking. Shade here is gonna scroll through my anime list. He's gonna pick out a bunch of shows, or one at a time. He's gonna pick out a show that he's never heard of, hopefully, that sounds obscure enough that he's pretty sure I don't remember it. And then I'm going to try and describe what that show is about, even though I don't remember it, while drunk. Let's see what happens.
Alright, so this is hard to say. What is Kono Mini Kuku Mo Utsukushi Sekai?
Kono Mini Kuku Mo Utsukushi Sekai. I think it's This Ugly Yet Beautiful World. Which, from what I remember, is a Gainax show about boobs. And it's, like, it's weird, because, like, okay, it starts off, like, with this really serious action scene, and then it becomes, like, a romantic comedy for, like, 10 episodes. But in the middle, there'll be, like, all these big action scenes, and boobs ever, like, there was, like, nipple boobs, like, full boobs. Oh. Like, boobs.
So, not even, like, playing around.
Nah, man. There was fucking real boobs.
This was like not even
midnight. And then in the last two episodes it suddenly goes full Ava and is like really serious, and I remember passing out while watching it. Like, I literally was so fucking bored, as I marathoned the show. I was bored and tired, and I could not, that's the only, it's like one of two or three anime that I've actually fallen asleep watching.
Really?
It was so fucking, yeah, it doesn't usually happen. It's hard for me to fall asleep while watching something.
I have fallen asleep many times while watching some anime. What is Shingetsu Tan Tsukihime?
That's Tsukihime. Tsukihime doesn't exist. Next question.
Oh.
That's legitimately the only appropriate answer. The Tsukihime anime doesn't exist.
Like, why it's is also it there,
been
then?
It's also been so long since I've seen it that I legitimately don't remember what it's about, like, other than that a guy can see death. It's the same plot as Kata no Kyokai.
Alright, well, that's very interesting.
It's a meme, you wouldn't understand.
What is Maho Tsukai ni Taisetsu na Koto?
I think that's the one. It has like a totally different name in English. That's the one about a girl who's like trying to become a wizard, and she has like three ahoge, like the antennas.
Oh god, no.
She has like three antennas. And she goes to the city to try to become, like, a wizard or something. God, I don't fucking remember. It was really boring. I remember that. I remember that it was really slow. It was one of those that, like, a few people had said was kind of good. So I was like, whatever, I'll check it out. And then I remember, like, just marathoning it and then, like, immediately remembering none of it. Oh, gee, you're doing a good job of finding stuff I watched, like, in 2007 speed watching.
I'm reading the longest titles that are not in English. Like, there's one that says Spriggan, but it's just
Spriggan is a good movie. I would remember that too well.
Exactly. So it's Spriggan. It's like almost English.
You probably saw Spriggan when you were like 5.
I don't know.
That's from like old. But then right here, olden days.
There's Kumo no Moku Yoku So. I can't even freaking read that crap.
Where?
Kumo
no Muko Yakusoku no Basho. That's It sounds like it would be now and then, here and there, but I don't think that's, no, that's Ima Soku no Iroboku. Oh, it's The Place Promised in Our Early Days. Okay, that's a shitty Makoto Shinkai movie. I know a lot of people will think that sounds like a paradox, because Makoto Shinkai is best known for 5 centimeters per second and Voices of a Distant Star and a bunch of other shit. That movie was boring as fuck.
Is that bullcrap movie we watched at Otakon?
No, that's the one he did after, okay, after 5 centimeters per second. That one also sucked. But The Place Promised in Our Early Days, from what I remember, it's like like, the first half of it's like a really dry and slow, like, romantic, like, thing. And then it becomes about, like, rocket physics.
What?
And then, like, there was this girl who was, like, in a coma, and they were trying to, like, they put her in a rocket and, like, fucking were trying to fly fast enough to wake her up.
How does that even make sense?
Why would that work? Was something like that. Don't take my word for it. That's how I remember it.
All right. We're gonna fly.
It's been a fucking long time.
Are we Superman? Okay.
We did not live in this house when I watched that movie, so it was quite a fucking
5 years.
Yeah, 5 years. It's a fucking while.
I can still remember shows from then. I remember most of Panty Pony Dash.
You
can remember.
Okay, you liked Panty Pony Dash. Well, I hated the Police Promise in our early days.
That's a good point. Hey, Panty Pony Dash is right here.
I could easily tell you the story of Panty Pony Dash. It's about girls. They live in an elementary school.
Was it? It was a high school.
Everything, live there. Everything about that sentence I didn't realize was wrong until I said it. Okay, next question.
Question? I'm just reading titles. They're not questions.
Shut up.
What is Kashimashi Girl Meets Girl?
Good question. That's also from... Do you have, like, a magnet to 2007? Like,
I don't know.
Like, late 2007 shows that I watched, or shows that I watched in that time, not that they came out then. Kashimashi Girl Meets Girl is a show about a guy...
At least you know this one.
Kind of. It's about a guy who gets hit by an alien spaceship, and it turns him into a girl. And then there's... There's like two girls who are in love with him. One of them's in love with him now that he's a girl, and the other one was in love with him before, and is now conflicted because he's a girl. And it's the love triangle between them. And if I remember correctly, the one girl can't, like, one of the girls who's in love with him, who falls in love with him when he's a girl, I think, she literally cannot see men.
What?
If I remember correctly, when she looks at men, she sees, like, a blurry image. I think that was it. I think she couldn't see men, and then she fell in love with him after he was a woman, and it was like, oh, if he turns back, then I'll lose him. But then I think he teaches her to see men again or something. I don't
know. How do you even teach that?
It had, like, it was really bad and stupid. It was one of those shows that, like, at the time that I watched it, I was like, this is pretty bad, but I guess it was okay. But if I watched it now, I'd be like, oh... Oh.
That's pretty fun. What is Utakata?
Utakata? Okay. I remember it's from the same character designer as Kitty Grade, which you could not possibly tell me to describe Kitty Grade, but you remember it, right? From Funimation Network? The one where the girl had the lipstick and she, like used, like, laser lipstick? And in the last episode, there's, like, a nuclear bomb and a deer, like, explodes.
What? This sounds awesome!
It's not quite what you think, but... What did That's Kitty Grade.
Dude!
Utakata was Madoka before Madoka. It was, like, a dark magical girl show. Like an out-of-its-way-to-be dark magical girl show. And I remember that I hated it, because I remember, like... It was just super slow, and it didn't seem like it was going anywhere. It didn't seem like it knew what it wanted to be. And then, like, the last episodes, it's like tries to be, like, all edgy and dark, but it was, like, this really boring finale. Like, the girl gets trapped in, like, a house, and the lady's, like, torturing her or something. And I just remember it being stupid, and I hated it. But the character designs are great. Because that dude can draw some porn.
That I don't know if that picked up on the mic, but that was an amazing part.
I hope it did.
What is Pale Cocoon?
Pale Cocoon is a 30-minute short cyberpunk-ish sci-fi movie that a lot of people really like, and I remember watching it and just remembering none of it even by the time I was done with it. Like, it wasn't bad. I just remember being like, oh, I watched that, and then remembering nothing. And that's how I felt about everything else the guy's done. And then he, like, people kept saying, like, he was great, and then he did fucking Patema Inverted, and that shit was awful, so, fuck that.
All right. What is Shinigami no Ballad?
That is a light novel adaptation, and the light novel. The funny thing about this is that what I remember best about it is how badly I wanted to read the book, because in like 2006 and 2007, Seven Seas Entertainment, who released the Boogie Pop novels, were releasing a bunch of light novels in the U.S., and no one else had been doing it at the time. So, but they would release them super fucking long after announcing them. They'd be like, oh, it's gonna come out this year, and they'd come out like 2 years later. It was obnoxious, but Shinigami no Ballad was one of the first ones they put out, and it sounded cool. It was about this a girl, like basically just a little girl god of death. That's all it was, and like she would
sound pretty cool.
She would watch people's like final moments basically, but she could never do anything about it. You know, she'd be all like emotional because they are dying, and then she'd just be like, "Well, I guess I gotta kill them." So mostly it was just a bunch of short stories of people in the last moments before their death. It's not very good. Really, it's just stories of people, like it's just random stories, but I wanted to read it so badly, and I remember I rented it from a library once, and then I just didn't even read it. Like I literally did not even read the first page. I borrowed it from a library, I took it back at some point later because I have a tendency to not read books, so I never read it. But I did watch the anime. It was 6 episodes long, and even though I don't remember anything about the anime other than the premise, the opening song I love. It's one of my favorite opens. How can I tell you this? I'm so sad to say to you, but don't put your face so close to me. Then I hear you say my name, so I cross the light to be with you.
Alright, well, that's pretty gay.
What's next?
What is Yokohama Kaidashu Kiko?
Yokohama Kaidashu Kiko. That's Yokohama Shopping Log. That is originally a 14-volume manga that I've been meaning to read for 8 years, which was seven years, which was adapted into 4 episodes worth of OVA. It is the best way to put it, this guy named Shiro, an anime blogger, former anime blogger, once described, he said that, that if Aria is the cannabis of slice of life, then Yokohama Kaidashi Kiko is like injecting heroin directly into your eyeballs. That's how he described it. It's like the slowest, most atmospheric, comfy, chilled, laid back, get yourself a fucking lazy boy, put on 3 blankets, and just like glaze over your eyes and watch nothing happen. It's about a robot girl, and she's in the post-apocalypse world, but it's like, it's basically like nuclear war happened, and then like we kind of got reset back to like an earlier time, and then everyone just went, well, the world's dying. Let's just live off the land, and so everyone's just kind of chill, and she occasionally drives into Yokohama and shops. So it's a Yokohama shopping log.
It's pretty chill. So what's writing been?
Writing Bean is fucking awesome. For once, you didn't ask about something I watched in 2007, but something I watched in 2010. Writing Bean is a fucking awesome 90s pulp OVA about this badass dude who drives a fucking, I think it was like a Mustang, it was some kind of nice-ass car, and he drives around, he's like a transporter, like a for-hire transporter, like he'll transport anything, he won't, no questions asked, you know? But he's a good guy at the same time. And from Writing Bean spawned Gunsmith Cats. So if you're a fan of Gunsmith Cats, have you heard of Gunsmith Cats?
I think I read the first 3 volumes because you have the manga.
First 2. I don't have number 3. But
2.
Yeah. Gunsmith Cats was like basically like, because the character Rally Vincent was in Writing Bean, but her character design is totally different in Gunsmith Cats. So it's like like almost an alternate universe sequel. The writing Bean is in, the character is in Gunsmith Cats. But it's really rad and really well animated. It's beautiful. It's awesome. I love it.
That's great. Yes. I rate 8 out of 8. what's Kacho Oji?
Kacho Oji, or like Galactic Old Man, basically, is known in English as The Legend of Black Heaven.
What?
And it is simultaneously the most awesome show and the most stupid show ever. Because on the one hand, it's about this like 40-year-old washed-up old businessman who was originally a rock star.
40-year-old ain't that old.
He was originally a rock star in his 20s with this band called Black Heaven, but then now he's just a washed-up salaryman. And he basically, there's some kind of galactic war going on, and some alien woman comes to him and, like, basically his rock can defeat the aliens. And so, for the first time in 20 years, he feels important and he gets to do his rock music. And the rock music in the show is fucking phenomenal. Like, the song that he wrote is amazing, the one he uses to defeat the aliens. But he kind of has to, like, balance this self-indulgent lifestyle where he's, like, the savior of the world and he's all cool against the fact that he's supposed to be a family man. And he's kind of a shitbag, and that's the point of the show, is, like, to explore the balance between him being a shitbag and him being a good guy. And in the end, it has this fucking amazing finale. But at the same time, a lot of the comedy, the attempts at comedy, are horrible. And there's always these side plots about these, like, three alien girls who are, like, these obnoxious side characters, have the stupidest side stories. And it's badly animated. The show is ugly as sin. The opening theme looks amazing. You've heard it. It's, you are my instigator, you are my aggravator. You are my space invader. Cautionary warning, I propose.
Yeah.
Fucking amazing opening, amazing video and audio. It's one of the best opening videos ever. And then the show looks like shit. But the ending is really great. It's a really uplifting show, and I recommend it to everybody because no one's fucking seen it. So go watch The Legend of Black Heaven. Yes?
What
is what?
What is Hoshizora Kiseki?
I don't remember. It was like a, like some fucking, like, student animation tier, like, bullshit. Like, it was like a 45-minute, really slow, boring piece of shit that was, like, literally a student animation. It's fucking horrible.
Well, that's
it would literally be like a 0.5 out of 10 if I were to rewatch it. Cuz it was one of the lowest scores that I had on my list way back when in the early days. It's bad.
What is Kaido Maru?
That's another really bad show, but Kaido Maru is more funny cuz it's like it was this, like, really overhyped attempt at being, like, this artsy, like, ninja flick. It's, like, 2 episodes long. I think it was, like, either 2 episodes or it was a 50-minute movie. But, it, like, tries to mix... It was, like, really early, like, 3D animation. And it was trying to mix 3D and 2D animation, but all of it looked really awkward and weird. And, like... I just remember it made no sense, and I watched it dubbed, and it was one of those hilariously bad dubs where, like, everyone's yelling and everything sounded like shit. So it was just, like, really embarrassing, and I remember watching it and fucking laughing in between sleeping. So, yeah, it's bad. But it was advertised constantly in magazines, like it was supposed to be some big deal. It's not. It's horrible. Again, Armitage III got the same treatment.
Yeah. And we already know your opinion on that.
Yes.
But I don't. So, this is bullcrap. I can't find nothing. Okay.
Well, we can end this at some point, but just keep scrolling until you find something that you want. Oh, you clicked on something. You stupid nerd. Giant Robo. That's a great show. I can't possibly describe Giant Robo.
What is Kage?
Kage? That's porn. That is a surprisingly... Kage is like the most interesting porn I've ever seen in terms of storyline. Because it's actually like... It's actually just like a ninja story. It's like about these like ninja women. And the only reason it has sex in it is because they'll sleep with guys and then poison them while they're sleeping with them.
Devilish.
But like it actually has like really well animated action scenes and stuff. So I remember watching it and being like, "Huh. I actually cared about something other than the porn in this." And that's never happened in any other porn that I've ever seen. So well,
we don't need to hear about your porn. Whoa, what is Gibo Mai?
I don't remember. It might also be porn?
That's
not... Oh, it's Crusher Joe. Oh.
I don't think I clicked on the right one.
I think Gibo Mai might be porn, so just be ready for that. That's 1919.
I hate freaking...
I hate Monday.
Ah!
I like how the other two you clicked on, Crusher Joe and 1919, are both also obscure as shit.
But I've heard of them.
You've heard of Crusher Joe and 1919? That's definitely porn.
Yeah, it's definitely porn.
Let's just go back.
That's...
God damn it.
Very clearly porn.
Oh my god, I keep clicking new tab! Gibo Mai is a really fucked up porn too, now that I remember what it is. It's got scat in it.
It's about rape!
I think it had scat in it. It's definitely about rape and bondage. But I think it and torture. I think it also had shit.
So what could you say about it?
It's a good I keep going. Come on.
Freaking ears. Doing? Jesus Christ.
You're killing me here, Shane. You're killing me. What's the next animes?
I keep on finding OVAs.
OVAs are scary because they're probably porn.
Okay. What is Kyoran Kazuku Nikki?
Dude, you need to watch that show because you'll like it. It's about... Okay. It's this, like... This woman who's like this dangerous criminal, she's like a lolly looking older woman with cat ears. She's a badass. And she has to marry this normal guy along with a robot that's like a big action robot with dreadlocks, but it's actually a child, and then a lion and a squid and this little girl all have to be their kids. The idea is that they took a bunch of criminals or dangerous people and made them into a family. What? And so they all have to, like live together. And, you know, at first they're all like, fuck this is bullshit, we're criminals, we do whatever we want. But then they all, like, become a family. And, you know, learn to, like, they all love each other and they fight together. It's really cool.
I cannot comprehend...
It's fucking batshit insane, but it's really cool.
Okay.
Oh, and every ending theme is different. There's like 6 ending themes that cycle through because each character has their own ending theme.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. What's Kanokan?
Kanakon.
Kanokon?
Kanokon.
Okay.
Kanokon is not porn, but it might as well be.
It's more porn.
It's like To Love Rue, or... You don't know what I'm talking about.
I know what To Love Rue is.
Okay, it's borderline porn. It's like just fan service harem anime. But it's actually kind of good. And I remember when I watched it, like, every episode I was like, this is fucking retarded, but I kept watching it because it had, like, fun elements. And it has one of my favorite endings ever, because the main character is in a love triangle, right? And at the very end of the show, after all this, like, crazy shit happens, because there's, like, this, you know, it's one of those that has, like, a plot, and so there's, like, fighting and stuff.
A plot.
And then at the very end, the one girl who was like his main squeeze is like all over him. The other girl's like, move over, bitch. And she goes, you know what? As long as you're his mistress and I'm his main bitch, then you can stay with him. And she's like, okay. And I was like, whoa, that's awesome. They just agreed to be a three-way couple. That's fucking rad. I thought it was the greatest thing ever. It was my favorite ending in all of anime. 10 out of 10, best show ever.
And then the guy from the show got on a rocket ship, and he banged a million girls, and then everyone gave him his money. There, buddy.
Yes, he was Jesse Wood. Thank you, Shane. If you don't get that one, watch the BronyCon vlogs from 2014.
Oh my god, there's OVAs and TVs and poop.
You don't have to check what they are, just fucking read names you don't recognize.
Okay, fine.
Tuaru Kagaku the Railgun! Yeah! What about Cat Shit 1?
I've heard of that.
It's called Cat Shit 1. When, did you actually watch Cat Shit 1?
I think I've watched like the first 15...
It's only one episode.
Yeah.
It's like one 15-minute episode.
Oh, well, I think I watched like the very beginning of it.
It was about bunnies with guns. Do you remember that? It was CG bunnies with guns?
Yeah, I think it was, I was going to watch it, but then, like, the stream broke.
The manga was called Apocalypse Meow. Greatest fucking title ever.
All right.
Go watch Cat Shit 1 if you like tactical military action carried out by bunnies. Anime's fucking weird. I'm realizing that anime's fucking weird.
Oh, it's been weird crap the whole time. Oh, my God.
Because it's so fucking weird.
Okay, what is Kuchu Buranko?
That's trapeze. That's one of my favorite shows.
Is it?
Yes.
Well, then...
That's the one that's all... That's all, Shanguri Nakarajo wa kitanda. Hukame na nanushi yume de kiss, kiss, kiss. Kiss, kiss, kiss. Doko e mo doko mare mo. Go make sure that camera's still filming, by the way.
Okay. We're almost done with the list of watched, so.
Are we still going?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
It's on 29 minutes.
Alright, it might not go much longer, so. Let's try to wrap this up.
Alright.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh!
Okay, what is. What is Kuragehime?
Kuragehime, that's Jellyfish Princess. Everyone knows that. That won't be entertaining.
Okay. I'm just a lame.
It's the one that's like
very good.
It's a Noe Tamina show. Get the next.
I don't even know who that is.
Noe Tamina, the block animation block man. Come, oh fuck, you're not even in anime.
I'm a faggot. All right.
Please read the next thing.
Okay. What is anemone? As in, I need the money.
Anemone?
Anemone. So what episode OVA?
I think that's like a music video.
Oh my god, you smell like booze.
Go to the next one. I think that's just a music video, and it was like nothing. Like, literally nothing.
What is Downloader?
That was also a music video.
God
that
damn.
I don't remember.
Why are there music videos on your anime list?
They're anime music videos.
Not
AMVs, but like actual animated music videos.
What is
Breaking the Habit by Linkin Park.
Oh.
Like that kind of thing.
What is... Therme Rome.
Oh god!
It's only three episodes.
Just thinking about the fact that I have to describe this. Okay. Thermo Rome. Get up and make sure the camera's still recording while I explain this.
Alright.
Thermaroma is... you can come back if it's recording.
You look like Skrillex, though.
Okay. Thermaroma is about... okay, it starts off in ancient Rome, and it's this guy who's a bathhouse designer. And he's in the bath.
What a job.
He's in the bath, and he teleports magically to a Japanese bathhouse in the current day. He doesn't know where he is, and there's no one there, but he observes the Japanese bathhouse, and he's like mind blown by the shit he's discovering. Then he gets teleported back to Rome and starts advancing bathhouse technology based on what he learned from modern Japan.
So what sent him forward and backward?
So the implication is that all of Rome's advancements in bathhousing were learned from coming to the future and looking at Japan's bathhouses.
That would create a crazy time paradox.
And the show is fucking hilarious. Highly recommended. They actually released the manga in the US in like these... here's the thing. Okay. I get why they did it this way. Because it's a great manga and it looks good. But they released it in hardback volumes. Like these big, awesome looking hardback volumes. And I'm like... I don't want to pay $20 for a volume of fucking Thermaroma. Like, yeah, it's really funny, but Jesus Christ. Oh, man. Do watch the show, though. It's pretty fucking funny.
All right. Well, this is, like, the last show. What is Star Jewel?
It's porn. It's about women growing dicks and fucking the power out of each other.
That's amazing!
We totally didn't have to re-record this because the camera ran out.
A plus acting.
Buy my t-shirt!